right, guys. So a bit of an idea of how I use the TFT on the Honda Africa Twin. This is by far not going to be a tutorial. There is plenty of tutorials sitting around YouTube at the moment, so you can definitely go and have a look at those. But this is just my understanding of how this works. So we'll go through the settings that I've got lined up from my user modes here, and we'll go into then into the other riding modes, which you might find a little bit interesting. If not, no worries. If you like this kind of stuff, give the video a thumbs up. Certainly subscribe to the channel. We're gonna get a little bit more into this kind of gear as I try and get a better understanding of how the Africa Twin works and adventure bike riding in general. So at the moment, we've got the bike set up in tour mode. Now, tour mode, per the book, smooth acceleration, even when riding with a passenger or with luggage. So you've got your power button, your engine braking as well, and you've also got your torque control, the gravel button, and the ABS. So I use the gold display throughout all of the riding modes. I love information, so the more information the better, and I'm pretty happy with that. Now, while we go into it, while we're right here on the tour mode, a bit of an explanation. So power, the P button there is the power value. So as you can see, it's got four settings. Now level one is the maximum power, level four being minimum. With the engine braking, so same again, level one is the strongest engine braking effect. Say that 10 times quickly. And level three is gonna be your weakest. So you can see the tour mode sitting in the middle, and then your torque control with the seven settings there. I've got that sitting at number three, with seven being the strongest torque effect, which slows the bike down with the power output, whereas level one is the weakest torque effect. So it allows that wheel to spin freely. And that's even better with the G button. So the G button here, which I've actually got lined up in my favorite, so I can activate or deactivate that whenever I need to, that creates a more direct feeling with the throttle to the rear wheel. So it basically allows the clutch to slip and eliminates that shift lag in between the gears on the DCT. That's my understanding of it. So I've got these set up at the moment. They're your normal modes, your tour, your urban for general busting around town, your gravel mode there, and of course, your off-road mode. With your off-road mode, the G button comes on automatically, which is ideal as well. And I've got my two user modes. So I've got a road use mode, which is user one. You can see I've adjusted the engine braking there. And of course, power is going to be the most amount that I want out of the twin. And then coming back down to the off-road mode, less power, so you don't get that jerky throttle response. You know, a good amount of engine braking as well, and the torque control there, I can adjust that. So let's have a quick chat about how you adjust that torque control as I go and play around off-road. Now, I'm probably gonna get some of this wrong. So holding down the enter button on the handle, on the controller there you go. So it allows me to go in. So I can turn the ABS off. As soon as you do that, it's a, do you really want to turn this sucker off? I don't. Had a bit of a situation recently where I'd literally just turned the ABS back on the gravel, and went into a corner a bit too hot. And if it wasn't for the ABS kicking in, I probably would have low-sided and ended up on the side of the dirt track. So I am gonna keep that on throughout my off-road riding. Then you got your torque control. So there's your seven settings that you can adjust. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now to turn this sucker off, see how it goes from 7 to 1. So you got to hold it down to the left. Same with the wheelie control, hold it down to the left and you can turn that off. Now in the event that you turn the bike off, and this is a bit of a gripe with most Africa Twin users, is that if you turn the bike off, you wander around, you want to get back on and go for a hoot, what it will do is it will automatically select level one for both, or I'll just do it manually, and it will leave it at level one. So you've actually got to manually turn that off. Okay, so, and that's allowed me to actually get out there and have a little bit of fun on the dirt, starting to get a bit more of a feel after going out a little while ago and just locking up that back wheel, learning how to slide this 250 kilo beast. having a bit more of a play with that. Only hassle I've had with this so far is once I've done all that, oh, it's going to work for me now. To come out of that, you hit the return button on the controller, on your left-hand controller, and it allows you to come back through here. And you've got all your other settings. Those settings can be changed around, but that's basically user modes there. I've actually found this pretty easy to use now. You do need to muck around with it a fair bit and get used to how it all works. You know, you've got a variety of different settings. You can go in here and play around with whatever you want. I got into the display straight away and changed everything to auto, changed everything to the gold display, and did all of that. Look, there's a lot involved. You really do need to read the book, but don't forget, it's not something that you don't need to be completely full bottle. All you are doing is having a play around with the controls, changing the bike around with its various modes and having a bit of fun there. So, take your time, get into it, have a look around. And if you've got any further questions, definitely leave me a comment below. Like I said, give the video a thumbs up. There'll be a few more of these bits and pieces coming out later on down the track. We'll have a play around and see what kind of trouble we can get into on the Africa Twin. All right, have yourself a good one, guys. Uru for now.